Welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you the proper way to do kicks in Tai Chi. Now, as you work through this little video about kicking, I would like for you to modify. If you need to do a toe touch instead, because that's where you are, that's perfectly fine. I would rather you do a modification than to overextend and then use compensating strategies, which is not going to teach you how to do this effectively over time. What's key to this is that we sit down on our windowsill and we remain seated. As we kick, I'll do a toe touch and you can follow me. We're going to kick with your right. As we toe touch, this part stays seated and goes back a little bit instead of off to the side or up. So you keep this in a nice seated position and it's sitting down on that windowsill. So as I kick, I'm actually thinking about sitting on the windowsill. I'm also thinking about placing my foot on a solid object. So as though it was sitting on a chair or a curb or quite literally the floor, but very light touch. So you begin by sitting down on that windowsill, making sure your hip is staying aligned, not popping out, not coming up, it stays down. And now let's just place your foot on a little curb. And imagine that on that curb is a little twig and you're just gonna scuff it away. Once you scuff it, you release and let go. Place your foot and then feel it. So now let's do to the other side. So to your right side, make sure you're sitting down on the windowsill. Let's just place your foot on a little curb. Imagine it very clearly in your mind. Scuff it away, place the foot down. Sitting down, place it on the curb, scuff it away. Sitting down, place it on the curb, scuff it away. Then release it. Try to place the foot and then fill it or weight shift to it, as opposed to flipping it out and then falling into it. Okay, we fall into our footsteps all day long. One of the skills of Tai Chi is that we place it, and then when we're ready, that's when we fill it. Okay, so let's try this again. We're gonna add the arms. The only thing you really need to remember about the arms is that they stay connected to the legs. So if I sit down, let's hold a ball, have it out in front as your counterbalance. And then as you toe touch or kick, make sure that your arms are in alignment with your leg. In other words, not out of here, but here. My knee here is connecting to my elbow, this knee connecting to that elbow. And as I come up, you can see how connected it is. It's still right over it. All right, so of course you don't need to go that high, just a light touch. Then we'll lift up and you can cross your hands, doesn't matter which one's in front for right now. Then again, line it up. It's not straight in front of the body, it's to your corner. Place it down. Sitting down, I'll do a tut touch. Then place it, push it down with the hands. Keep sitting down on that windowsill. Toe touch. Place it, press it down with the hands, weight shift. Press it down. Press it down. You can do a low kick. Or you can do a high kick if you want. And you have good balance, keep this soft. Press it down. And press it down. So three things to remember. The qua is back and soft. You're sitting down. The second thing is keep your arms aligned. And the third thing is place it and then fill it. So good luck with your kicking. Just start out at the area or at the level that you're very successful with, and then you can build on it from there. Thank you for joining me, and I look forward to sharing more Tai Chi with you as you go along your Tai Chi journey.